In this video, we will explain acceleration in special relativity. In classical mechanics, acceleration is defined as the time derivative of the velocity vector. In special relativity, we use a similar equation, but instead of a time derivative, we use a derivative with respect to the proper time tau. Since proper time does not change after a Lorentz transformation, b mu will transform in the same way as u mu does, which makes b mu a 4 vector. If you use the time derivative instead, b mu would not be a 4 vector. You can also write this as the second derivative of x mu with respect to proper time. Before we actually calculate b mu, let's first look at an interesting connection between 4 velocity and 4 acceleration. Since the square of any 4 velocity is always equal to c squared, the derivative with respect to proper time tau will be 0. However, we can also use the product rule, which results in 2 times b mu u mu. This must be 0, which means that in Minkowski space, 4 velocity and 4 acceleration are always orthogonal to each other. Now, let us calculate the 4 acceleration. The derivative with respect to proper time can be written as gamma times a regular time derivative, and 4 velocity is given by gamma times cv. In order to calculate this, we need the time derivative of the Lorentz factor gamma, which yields gamma cubed times the inner product of velocity and acceleration, divided by c squared. For the zero component of b mu, we just have to differentiate gamma. But for the spatial components, we have to use the product rule. In summary, these are the components of the relativistic 4 acceleration b mu. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching!